Please introduce yourself and what you do.
Hi, I'm Charlie de Rusett and I work for Vine Publishing. I'm the chief exec and we're a full service communications agency, but we also specialise in regional publications.
Right. And so from a personal perspective, what's your objective of using social media and how do you combine your kind of your private and your business, seeing as you're kind of 25 or something? So yeah. how do you run your life there?
I guess from a social perspective, because we're really busy at the minute and we're working quite long hours and stuff, it's a good way of keeping in contact with my brothers and sisters and watching what they're doing in their life. A great thing about social media is it's so visual with Facebook. You know, you've got videos coming on and, you know, and pictures and comments, and you can immediately interact with them instantly. A lot of the applications now do pop-ups like they would on a text, so that's quite useful. I also use it to organise events with friends, so it can tie in and I can see what I'm doing. If I accept an event and I log into my Facebook calendar, I can see what I'm doing at the weekend, so I don't double book things. And then I guess the way that integrates with my business life is that because I've grown up on it, that I can see how the tools work from a marketing perspective as well. So I like a lot of brands and companies that I work with and stuff, so I can keep up to date with them so that when I'm making customer calls or looking after accounts and stuff, I can see that, I don't know, a client's run a particular event for charity and therefore I have a topic of conversation to talk with them about.
And how do you manage all that? Is that, you know, do you... Because you use Salesforce, you guys, don't you?
Yeah. So I guess Salesforce is really useful in the fact that one of their recent updates is the fact that they've got a plugin where you can actually, within the account, follow their Twitter account, follow their LinkedIn account. And again, on that topic of conversation front, that's really, really useful for when I'm making sales calls and even a cold call for the first time to a company, that I can integrate their Twitter and LinkedIn account with their Salesforce profile to give me a much wider picture of who they are and who I'm speaking to.
Yeah. And so generally, as far as organising your social media life and using the tools, when do you have particular times of the day when you do it? How do you organise yourself around all these bits of technology?
Well, one of the things that we use and we get all our clients to use is obviously tweet schedulers. And so we'll spend as a company for ourselves maybe like 2 hours every couple of weeks and find out what topics of conversation we want to talk on. And then we'll schedule them into the tweet scheduler at particular times of the day when we know our Twitter followers are active, from using analytical tools that show us that. So for us, it's, you know, first thing in the morning when people are commuting in on the trains and they're on their mobile devices.
Yeah.
Again, at lunch when they're having a sandwich, and also at the end of the day, which I think is quite a regular pattern for a lot of businesses. But for me personally, the way I look after my own LinkedIn profile and Twitter account, I'm on my mobile device, and that allows me, for instance, I was at a golf club yesterday having a marketing meeting with the
not playing golf
business development director. Now, unfortunately, I'm not very good at golf. Take me all day to carry around. But it was a great opportunity to use the photo application that Twitter has, take a photo of the course, and tweet about the marketing meeting, and then naturally that provokes topics of conversation for a lot of the followers that wanted to be out on the golf course, and you know they're engaging with our brand through doing that.
Excellent. And so what sort of setup do you are you Apple or you Microsoft? What sort of technology setup do you have? What sort of phone do you have?
I use Apple. I think because we're a design agency, we love the Apple brand. We love what it stands for. We love what Steve Jobs originally set out to do, which was to change the world, and we think he's doing that. And I think that just the iPhone's a really good platform as a mobile device because so many people use it as a smartphone. It's the, you know, biggest seller on the market. So,
and so are there any other tools? Salesforce, using Twitter schedulers, are there any other tools? You're obviously big LinkedIn fans, are you?
Yeah, massive LinkedIn fans. LinkedIn for us is a great way to generate business. It allows us to see organisational structures very easily, find out the names of people we want to speak to, get backgrounds on them so that we can look to see if anyone within our organisation went to, say, school with them, or whether we've got a particular interest in common or something like that, so that we can focus on the relationship rather than trying to get, you know, business off them immediately, because as we all know, that doesn't work. You know, I think I hear Robert Barker use the term trustability quite a lot.
And so from a blog perspective, do you blog? Do you publish yourself, or how do you, do you write anything yourself, or?
I have a personal Twitter account, which is me with my business head on. So I'll share things that I'm reading, say on LinkedIn news or business.
So for publishing press. For you is basically Twitter, not writing a blog.
I don't write a blog. As a company, we obviously publish regional magazines, and therefore we share a lot of our content on various blog sites that goes into the magazines and stuff.
Right.
Will we start to use blogs more personally? Will I start to use blogs personally more? Yeah, I think I probably will.
Video blogs, I suppose.
Yeah, and I think I'll also do that through, you know, using skills in the team. So we've got guys that make videos and stuff, and so we might decide to talk about a topic of conversation, and link up with, say, Ted or something like that.
Okay, and so finally, what would be your tips for a business that doesn't really get social media, or an individual that's wondering how they use it for their business to get more business? And what are your tips?
The revolution's already begun.
Yeah.
It's not a fad, it's here to stay.
Yeah.
You only need to look at some of the facts that are coming out that, it's overtaken pornography as the number one activity on the web.
Yeah.
Facebook has more visits than Google does, and I just think.
But how would you get started? Where do you get people to start? You do social media training and things for people, don't you? What do you get people to do? What's the first thing you get people to do?
We try and get people to understand that social media is like word of mouth on steroids.
Yeah.
You know, historically we might have been able to tell two or three people in the pub about a good experience, 10 people about a bad experience. Now, if I go to a restaurant and I've had a great meal, then I can include that restaurant in my Facebook posting, which means it's posted on their wall. My friends can then interact with it, and then therefore suddenly virally that restaurant's brand's been spread exponentially. So first of all, I'd say to people, social media is there to access large networks of your potential customer bases. And therefore, if you're going to start up, look at who to follow, who's relevant to your business, and try and start up topics of conversations with them that, shows you're used to them.
Brilliant. Charlie, thank you very much.
Thank you.